We finally do this after I don't know how many cancel dates because Diana's so busy.
Long overdue. Oh please, Janice canned me the last time.
That is not true. That is not true.
It is true.
Okay, just to give you guys perspective, Diana and I go back a really long way. Yeah. We both went to college together. We're proud. Xavierites. Hold on, one second. All right. So let me just take in the house a little bit. Lottery with this one. Maine kya paap kiya tha previous janam mein? Look at this house.
It's old, it's my family home. It's my mom's side of the family actually. My dad moved in, which I think is quite cool.
Oh, he was a garjaman. How cute.
I mean, there was so much space, so I mean, my mom said, why not?
I think that's also going to happen when you get married.
Maybe. It's a great after party spot, if I may say so myself.
But hold on, you know, there's so much of art.
Yeah.
And this place is so beautifully done. You know, if someone dropped a glass of wine or, you know, got a little rowdy.
It's great because you won't see it. The floor is so crowded. It's an old mosaic floor. It's actually 100 years old, if not more. And so you don't see anything that falls on the floor, which is actually great.
So you allow people to get drunk in here?
Yeah. I mean, what else would you do in here?
Guts. You know, normally when you go to a sort of filmy home, there are lots of pictures of the actor, you know, on the wall, their photo shoots.
I can't handle that. If I had to wake up every morning and look at my face on the wall, it would freak me out. So no, I would. There's literally one picture of me.
Yeah.
That's the only picture I have, and that's because I love the photo and I love the woman in it, and it was one of the my most favorite campaigns I did for Grassroots, Anita Dongre.
Okay, tell me which is the corner over here that you generally, that you know, if I need to come over and we're gonna have a cup of tea together, where will I find you chilling?
That is my spot.
Okay.
That's my couch. I feel like I could live there. Eat, sleep, live.
Okay, so you were talking about pieces of art that, you know, your family has done up and that you found rolled away in trunks. Show me, na, some. Come. Okay, Diana, I believe you've put in a lot of work into our reunion. What have you done? Because, you know, now it's around 4 and I have to be fed every 2 hours, otherwise I become a cranky child.
Me too. I'm the same.
So she's the same.
I'm
from
the same.
College.
I am. I can eat. Yeah, never mind.
Yeah.
So I recently started baking. Just because, you know, I thought it would be fun. I hate cooking, by the way. It's a bit ironic because I love to eat, but I hate to cook. But baking is interesting. I mean, I find that that's therapeutic in a way, and it's exciting, and it doesn't take so long. It's not so messy. You know, you can very quickly put something together.
Show me what you've baked, and then we'll talk a little bit more about that.
Brownies.
Yes. Brownies aren't particularly good looking, huh?
I mean, come on. I made them, okay?
I mean, it's
allowed.
It's gonna take a while for you to get on MasterChef.
Yeah, I know. What to do? Okay. As long as they taste good.
Are we gonna decorate them? Or
we could.
Eat them at this?
No, we could. Okay. 27. Here's your icing cone. Clearly, I don't have a very steady hand.
Ooh.
For you.
Ooh.
And for me.
Very nice, very nice.
Wait, that's cute.
Okay, so I'll put.
Wait.
Okay. Oh, S.
Wow, I think I'm better than you.
This bee is not looking good.
Is the ugliest bee I've seen in my life. Anyway.
Okay, so I'm gonna taste your brownies. Wait, that sounds.
Not saying anything.
Yeah, no, I'll taste
you must
the brownies.
Taste
the
brownies made by me. You can be honest, since you have been being honest all this while.
It's really good. I'm not joking. I was making faces earlier, but actually it's really good.
Gooey?
It's gooey. This one's actually a lot more gooey.
Yeah.
But this one's it's really good, Dee. So all of these are for me, right?
No. The one with D and P is for me.
It would be here. But tell me, when do you get into baking, yeah? Because, I mean, I remember the Diana from college was not domestic at all.
I'm still not domesticated.
Eat your D.
But, I mean, I love food and I love dessert.
Mm.
Oh, wow, these are really So my boyfriend and I actually started baking together.
Ooh, boyfriend and you started baking together.
And he's very good at this. He cooks, he's a very good cook. Like whatever he cooks tastes really good. And I suck big time. So I started off as being just the helper. I was the assistant who used to stir.
Like, what did you guys start off making together?
So brownies was one of the first things. I mean, we did mousse one time, which turned out really good. Mm. Blue label mousse.
Blue label mousse?
You just put a whole shot of blue label in there.
Nice. What time was this? 3 a.m. in the morning?
Yeah, around 12.
Oh, not as much. sounds like a late night plan.
Yeah.
Okay, Rana, I'm definitely taking a few of these home. So you've got a doggy bag packed for me inside, right?
Please. Lots, I'll give you. Don't worry.
Very good.
Clearly, you don't want the brownies, you only want the samosas.
No, yeah, I'm eating the shell of the samosa.
You don't like my brownies, I know it.
That sounds so vulgar.
How?
You don't like my brownies.
Not asking.
Have you gotten used to the filmy ways of the industry?
Yeah, I think now I can say that I'm a filmy person.
What?
I'm halfway there.
So one second, let me give you guys context, okay? In college, you were like this typical sobo person. Sobo means South Bombay person, who was really shy, sort of introverted, and then you sort of kept getting more and more and more extroverted through the senior years.
I'd say I'm still an introvert. When you did one of my first few interviews, by the way, was Janice interviewing me for Cocktail, and it was a disaster because I think I was so scared and nervous that I answered in like monosyllables. I was like, yes. I've become more confident as a person now. I've kind of broken out of my shell. Along the way, I guess organically, I've, you know, made friends with people in the industry. I don't feel like an outsider anymore. I feel like now I'm part of this industry, which feels great actually. It took a while for me to break in, but now I feel like I'm part of it.
And I want to wrap up this segment by asking you, you know, you've been really picky and really cautious about the kind of work that you've been doing. Where do you see yourself now going career-wise, like within the film space?
You know, that the process of finding the right film takes some time, which is why I've taken my time with it and I'm not rushed myself. I don't like putting pressure on myself that way. So, and I want to enjoy what I'm doing at the end of the day,
that's
right?
So,
I don't know, I feel like in this industry, sometimes there's this fixed formula of, oh, you need to, you know, do this many films a year and you need to like be out there and
dancing at events and weddings.
So for me, it's a personality thing as well. Right. So, you know, I would rather do something even 100% and give it my all rather than doing 5 different things at one time and giving them all like 10% each, you know. Mm. Sorry, the math was completely off there.
D, I fed your soul with my soulful questions, but D, where is my tea?
Coming right up, Jay. Right behind you.
Oh, thank you, Abhay. Okay, D, please make my tea.
Okay.
I'm just going to keep saying that over and over again.
Why do I have to make your tea? But who can make
your
own tea?
Because first of all, I don't drink tea.
Actually, yeah, I keep forgetting, like, I'm the host and you're my guest, so I should make you tea.
Yeah, this is your own house.
But now I keep forgetting that because, like, I've known you for 20 years. Not 20. How long have you known me?
How old you're making us, Diana? Please, we do not know each other for 20 years. No, we were not in college 20 years ago, you guys. No.
Okay, sorry. Doodh wali chai?
Thoda sa.
Okay. Thoda sa means really thoda sa?
No, thoda aur. Thoda aur.
Oof, Janice.
Lots of money, don't open it. And one shakkar.
So demanding, your host is.
Chalo, chai le lete wahan pe. This is yours, that is mine.
That's yours, yeah. I have very little milk. Okay.
Okay, I just want to start off telling you guys that Diana's a little cuckoo. Okay, so if I do, this is the hammer.
Janice is real. It's real.
She gets irritated and she puts it back. What are these OCDs?
It's really bothering me. Okay. And also, it's not. Wait, oh, stop it, Janice! Wait.
Yeah. This is so much fun.
Wait, hold on. Just give me a sec, okay, guys?
And you're trying to convince me that you have parties over here. What crap?
When there's enough alcohol, it's okay.
Shit. Those turtles were in the wrong place.
Yeah, they were. They really were. Okay, don't catch it. Okay, fine. Go ahead.
Okay, the segment is called Quick Bites with Janice. It should have been called Quick OCDs with Diana. Okay, you ready? No, okay. I'm going to use it.
Okay,
beat
fine.
You.
Okay.
Okay, no, not to beat her, not to beat her. That was a joke. Some fan is going to be like, how dare you?
How dare you, Janice?
A famous historical personality you'd like to go on a dinner date with?
I have one. Kurt Cobain. I was a huge fan in college actually.
The worst thing someone can do while eating is? Name a food item that is universally loved, but you actually don't like it all.
Pizza?
What?
I love pizza. I can, it's okay.
If you had to describe your love life with the name of a dish, it would be? You're a pretty rocking love life, so think of that.
Biryani? I love biryani. Like, I love it. I can eat it like day, night, morning, breakfast, afternoon.
The weirdest thing you've put in your mouth is?
Doodi.
Doodi is rather
normal. I hate doodi. It's disgusting. Ugh.
The best thing you've eaten on a film set is?
I always ask for the sheera on a film set. For some reason,
sheera?
Yeah, they make it very well. The sweet one in the for breakfast in the morning.
Okay, the co-star with the best dabba is?
I have to say, Anand Rai is... Like, he's so fond and he's so passionate about food. So we always have bonded on, like, over food. So when we were shooting for Happy Bhag Jaegi in Punjab, we were in Amritsar. Like, we'd have three lunches. Then we'd have, like, we'd take two breaks for tea. And each time there was, like, the most amazing food ordered from the best places. So it was, yeah.
Finally, if you were allowed to go crazy in a grocery store, what section would you go crazy in?
Probably the confectionery section with all the chocolates.
The chocolates and the French fries diet.
The tarts, the pastries, dense chocolate cake.
I hate you.
Dutch truffle.
I hate you. Okay, giving.
You've got a long trek home, don't you?
I know, you could put more sugar in my tea.
Who said one spoon?
I'm kidding. Thank you for having me.
Thank you
so much
for coming. See you soon.
Bye.
Bye. Enjoy your trek home.